My child came and told me, Amma, in our school there is a birthday party. I think there's a birthday party, the big way, I suppose, nowadays. There's a birthday party, my son, my friend's house, they take us to some five-star restaurant. Some well-off parents can take. There's nothing wrong because everybody has their way of doing birthdays. There's nothing, I will comment on that, going to five-star hotel is less or not good or nothing of that sort. That's their parents' wish. He went once, I think his classmate's birthday was there. And my child, Rohan, my son, went to birthday party, came and said, Amma, it was so good. And my birthday, I want to take. I said, no, Bill, you can't take. He said, why? I said, Rohan, please remember, how much it will cost? Let us talk about it. Each child, let us take 1,000 rupees. You call about 50 people, your class. How much it costs? 50 into 1,000. Is how much? 50,000 rupees. He said, Rohan, please remember, you know, I told there was a person who used to come and drive our car. I said, he has two children. They are as bright as you are. Okay? Their school fees are probably in those days 10,000. If you give 20,000 to them, they can go to a better school, beta. For your birthday, I'm not denying you should not do, etc. I will buy samosa. Okay? I will buy samosa and rasna packet. Or nimbu sharbat, something there. No, mango or drink was there. What is that? Maza, not maza. Fruity. Yeah. Fruity in those days. I'm talking about 25 years back. So I will spend for 50 children plus our driver's children, everyone, you know, all together this much money. More than that, I think you should not spend because what you are doing is wrong according to me. Those two children will not go to school, whereas you spend 50,000. And he didn't like it. What I said, he didn't like it. He said, oh, you always give me hishob. That means you always give me plus, minus, always a balance sheet. I said, think over it. I will give you 3 days' time. And after 3 days, he came back and said, okay, I agree, but along with samosa, you should give us one gulab jamun or something. I said, fine. Okay? So I told, and in front of him, I gave 10,000 to our driver's children in front, through his hand. I said, Bill, from your account, there's a 50,000 rupees. Out of that, this is the way you have spent. This much money is left, and this you should give it to some good cause. And I used to take my children, when I wash vessels, I used to take my children to wipe them. You have to take your children. Fortunately, I had a job like this, where I go to Lambani tribal area, etc. I used to take my children. Come with me. I can show you they are very good children there. They don't have an opportunity. Is it not your duty? So he used to tell me, you make me so guilty, Amma, to spend any money. And today, because every time he'll bring one case like that. So today he says, Amma, what you did was a fantastic education, that when we spend so much money, we never think of someone else. And that sense of caring for others. You know, for example, you know, we have a cook, and we had a cook always gets food. So the cooks normally used to eat in the kitchen. I told one day, Rohan, I was talking about equality in life or some topic. When they become 14, 16, I treated them like adult. Just like adult. At least after 14 boys, after 16, no, girls also 13 only have to do now, 1 year early. I treated them like adults and we'll have a conversation on a dining table. I talked about equality and I was talking about slavery in America. Equality is so important in life. Then he said, Amma, if that is equality, will our drivers, will our cook eat on the same table as ours? For a minute, I never thought about it. I said, yeah, why not? And he made it a point, our cooks eat on the same dinner table. But our cooks were hesitating, no, we don't want to eat. Then, you know, I made a samjhota, like you can eat after we eat. If you feel like eating, no, you don't want to eat with us. At least you sit, use the dining table and eat on the dining table. It may be a small move, but that made a lot of awareness for my children, equality in life. When he was in our Cornell school, Rohan's birthday came and I was thinking he was abroad in those days, what he will do. I would have been unhappy. This is my subjective opinion. If he spends so much money on a birthday, which comes every year, why waste that kind of money? It is not something like fantastic thing. It is not like we are Mahatma Gandhi born on October 2nd. We are ordinary people. We are just ordinary people. Let us not think that we are too great. If somebody says, oh, what do you think of yourself? I said, I'm a very ordinary person. Very ordinary person, but the situation made me great. the situation made me great. I'm very ordinary than like anybody else. You should bring up this idea with your children's mind. Look, my child, you are ordinary. Just because your father has money or I have money, you are not extraordinary. Money comes due to various reasons. Okay? And money, what you have, has a cause. That I made it to my children in a very young age. And when he was in Cornell, he wrote to me, and I have that email even today. He said, every mother works, every mother looks after her child, but I'm proud my mother looks after someone's children. Isn't that the best compliment I can think of? He got a scholarship. Then he got a scholarship, and he sent the very little money. He must have had 1 lakh rupee or something, you know, not great money. He wrote to me, Amma, this money should be spent on my birthday to all those jawans who died in a parliament attack in 2001. They died there so that we can live in free democratic India. It is not a big money. It is not a big money. But that idea of sharing wealth with somebody, idea of being sensitive, someone is poor and they have a right to live, and making equality along with our own driver and cook, you know, such ideas you have to initiate to your children. That is very important. Most of the time we don't do that because we think what others will think, what is the status, suppose my neighbor comes, my cook is eating on the dining table, what they think of us, you know, all those false values, all those tightened compartments we build around what people think. Let them think what they think. You cannot live on people's opinion. You have to live on your own opinion. And that you should understand to tell your children. Children will be, you know, for many years, children will carry your values. Later, once they are married, their wife's value, once they are exposed to different values, you know, that goes on changing. But to some extent, great extent, you can reflect it. Yes, please.